The Investment Coordination Committee under the Philippine National Economic Development Authority has approved the NAIA Consortium's proposal to rehabilitate, operate, and maintain Manila's main airport. We now have on the line Socioeconomic Planning Secretary Ernesto Pernia. Good to have you back on, Secretary Pernia. Welcome to the program.
Yes, good afternoon, Kathy.
So how significant is the approval of NAIA Consortium's airport rehab?
That's pretty good. It has been rather fast. The way it was approved.
But NEDA had earlier returned the 102 billion peso offer of the NAIA consortium because it required another round of revisions. So what were the conditions or requirements satisfied to approve it this round?
That's kind of normal for projects, especially unsolicited PPP projects. It's not unusual that there's a back and forth a couple of times or three times before PPP and solicited proposal is approved.
Sure, but
so no problem there.
What sort of back and forth though happened? Because this was supposed to happen a couple of months ago. Tugade was already doing some timelines and now it's already delayed. Could you take us through the process there in which it was finally approved?
Well, one important thing about PPP project is we don't want the government to have to provide direct subsidy, warranty, or any guarantee of any kind, direct guarantees. So, because in the previous PPP processing, in the previous administration, there were so many of these sovereign liabilities. Fiscal liabilities that the government incurred with PPP.
All right, so that was removed. The government not to have any direct guarantees. What else?
No direct government, no direct subsidy, warranty, guarantee, no agreement on that there will be a no complete compete clause, meaning that the airport will be shielded from competition from other airports, in other words, yeah.
And that was the reason for the back and forth for the last couple of months? That was contention?
Among other things, because, the concession agreement has to be perfected before it can pass the hurdle.
All right. Either way, it's already delayed, Secretary Pernia, and the next step is a Swiss challenge, and that's going to take 60 days. So what sort of timeline do you expect then going forward, just to manage everyone's expectations?
Yes, if the Swiss challenge starts, shortly after, like October 1st, then you count 60 days, perhaps by early December, either the Swiss challenge, the Swiss challenger wins, or he or she loses, and so the NAIA consortium will go ahead.
All right. So, what other infra projects have you taken up and might be approved in the next couple of days or weeks?
Well, the Bohol-Panglao International Airport ONM and some augmentation. That requires just some revision.
So you're now going through that process of back and forth then for Bohol-Panglao?
Yes, it's practically on, but there just needs to be some revision in the facing of the proposal.
And how soon do you expect NEDA to approve the Bohol-Panglao?
That can be done. That can be done very quickly because it had already gone through so much discussion and cleansing and making sure that everything else is okay.
All right. What about Ramon Ang's unsolicited proposal on the elevated expressway and redevelopment of Bandakan Oil Depot? What's the latest there?
That's still quite far in the processing of projects, because that has just been bruited about very recently. So that's not yet in the pipeline, in fact. Not formally in the pipeline.
What else is in the pipeline? Big ticket projects before the end
year? PPWH project called the Pasakau Balatan Coastal Tourism Highway was approved.
How much for?
How much?
Yes, sir.
I don't have the figure here, but it's quite a major project that will boost tourism.
And it's exactly this. I mean, it's really crucial that the underspending gets moving. I just spoke with economist Doti Chikiampo, and he cited the continued underspend as a reason that GDP for the full year will be unable to land at least 6% growth. So where does that put us, the underspending and growth of at least 6% for the year, with the kinds of projects that you've already approved or likely to approve in the pipeline?
Well, you are aware that we lost 6 months of nice weather for construction, and validity of the project of the 2019 budget really effectively only got on starting July, and that's the start of the rainy season. And as you know, we have had so many rainy days, and this of course prevented the construction phase, the construction rhythm of projects.
So it's a stretch to achieve at least 6% growth. Where are we going to end by the end of this year for GDP?
It's a stretch for what?
Will it be a stretch to reach at least 6% GDP growth for the full year then, because of the underspend?
No, that's still reachable. That's reachable. Because household consumption spending has picked up, and inflation is, still on a downtrend. So it's not unthinkable that we will reach 6% or more.
All right. Well, I thank you so much for joining us, Secretary Pernia. Much appreciate the update there on the list on the pipeline of the big ticket projects.
Okay. Thank you. We'll be right back.